mentioned also the Prime Minister announced in his Independence Day speech the launch of the National Digital Health Mission, which sounds absolutely wonderful as an idea, as a concept. But you've seen it from your days at Aadhaar that whenever we talk about digital, a fundamental question about the access to it arises. And we're looking at it now when you talk about a digital divide in online schooling. A new study shows that 27% of students in government classes don't have access to, say, a device to get a digital education. So when we talk of a digital health mission in a country like India, where there are so many different standards of access, how do you actually look at that? And you, of course, see, face this whole controversy in Aadhaar as well. So you're well versed with the issues here.
There was no controversy in Aadhaar. It's perfectly fine. So anyway, I think a digital divide is something we should worry about. But digital divide does not mean having a device in everybody's hands. That'll take a long time. It's about providing access, which could be like a public call office, you know, a customer service center where you go and access the healthcare. And so if you're able to, for example, create electronic health records of your diagnostics and your ECGs, EEGs and all that, and if they're all stored on a cloud, like a digital locker, and when you go to a new doctor for a consultation, if you can just pull out your records and show it to the new specialist for advice, that is something everybody can have. They don't need to have a device with themselves. So I think universal digital access does not necessarily mean a device in everybody's hands. Mm-hmm. It means that wherever they go, they can get access. For example, if you look at payments today, the people who have smartphones use UPI-based smartphone payments. The people who have feature phones can also use UPI. Mm-hmm. And the people who have no phones can go to an Aadhaar-enabled payment system, use their biometric and withdraw money. So you have to design it for universality, even when you're using a digital backbone.
Mm-hmm. No, I take the point that if you don't need a device, Leslie, and you've, for accessing a universal health system. But when you look at issues, and of course you've talked about education as well and looked at solutions, when we look at what's going on currently with online classes or education, how do we address those inequalities which arise?
Well, again, I think online classes, we tend to think that it is about a phone and looking at a video of a teacher. I think it's much more than that. And if you look at the government's Prime Minister's eVidya program, which is backed by the Diksha infrastructure, it allows people to be offline. It allows people to use their textbooks and a local phone. It allows people to go to a village computer service center and access there. Mm-hmm. In some states, people are printing out the worksheets and giving it to people who don't have devices. So we have to think through all these. What do you do with people who have phones, no phones? How do you deliver it to them? So I think a lot, and then you can use the television, you can use the radio. So I think we have to look at it in a more holistic manner. It's not just about one device and watching a teacher.